Hi there, this is Ranjit from tech2bus.com, and today I'm going to talk about budget chips from Intel, and they use the Sandy Bridge architecture. A couple of weeks back, I had suggested a system, a budget computer system, but that was based on AMD Athlon X2. And a lot of users have emailed me that they want to build a budget entry-level computer, but they want to use the Intel parts. Luckily, we have components from Intel that's using the latest architecture, that's the Sandy Bridge, and they are the budget line of chips. Basically, if you remember, do you remember the Pentium chips that were launched by Intel last decade? They were the premium chips. But now what Intel has done is that these Pentium chips, they have again launched these Pentium chips, but these are being marketed as mid-tier chips, not the top performers. And recently, just the first week of September, Intel also relaunched the Celeron-based processor based on the Sandy Bridge architecture. So these new Pentium and the Celeron chips offer great computing at a very low price. So let's have a look at these new chips. These new budget chips fall under the Core i3 chip. Under the Core i3, it's the Pentium chip. And under the Pentium chip is finally the Celeron chip. So first, we'll look at the Pentium chip in detail. To differentiate these Pentium chips from the i3 chips, Intel has made all these Pentium chips dual core, and hyperthreading is disabled in all of them. Also, the CPU turbo mode and the Intel Quick Sync technology is disabled. But these chips also get the integrated GPU and the HD graphics 2000 is included. These new Sandy Bridge Pentiums fall into two lines, the G800 and the G600. The top two chips are of the G800 lineup and the bottom two are of the G600 lineup. Again, to differentiate between the G800 and the G600, what Intel has done is that in the G800 chips, the memory support, that's DDR3, is up to 133 MHz, and in the G600 series, it's only up to 1066 MHz. If you're looking for these chips, I suggest looking at the G840 or the G620 chips. That makes the most sense. The last chip, that's the fourth row, G620T, is an interesting chip. Notice the TDP, it's just 35 watts. So if you're making a home theater PC or a PC where you require low power, look at this chip. For the Celeron lineup, the top three chips are dual core chips, and the last chip, the only chip, is a single core chip. In terms of architecture, this Celeron chip is very similar to the Pentium Sandy Bridge chip. The only thing is that the maximum clock rate has been clocked up to 2.5 GHz. In my opinion, the second Celeron chip, that's the G530, offers the best bang for the buck. So if you're looking to build an entry-level computer on a budget, you can use this Pentium or the Celeron chip with the Intel H61 chipset. Compared to AMD X2 build, this Intel and a Celeron build computer will be again about $20 to $25 more expensive, but I feel that these are much better processors because they are built on the Sandy Bridge architecture, thus will perform better than an Athlon X2 chip. At the time of recording this video, both the Pentium and the Celeron based Sandy Bridge chips were not available in India. If you feel this video was helpful, please click on the like button given below. That's it for now. This is Ranjit for tech2bus.com, and hopefully I'm going to see you in my next video.